Hello friends, this video on Atom and Molecules part 12 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please pay attention here, little tricky concept here. Let's understand the mole concept. For example, hydrogen will react with oxygen to form water. This is a balanced chemical reaction. Now, to validate this reaction in the lab, we have to weigh hydrogen, we have to find the weight of oxygen, and we have to find the weight of water. What do you think is the minimum amount you can weigh in the lab without using very hi-fi instrument? It has to be in grams, right? You can measure 1 gram, 2 gram, or even milligram, but let's say gram is a standard value. So this way you can do in grams. Right, weight in grams. But if you remember the concept which I told you, this equation signifies that one molecule of hydrogen is reacting with half molecule of oxygen, or let's balance. Let's make it like this. Let's double this. Two molecules of hydrogen react with one molecule of oxygen to form two molecules of water. Okay. So the concept was that two molecules of hydrogen will react with one molecule of hydrogen to give two molecules of water. But actually, you can't weigh one molecule because the weight of one molecule is very, very less. Actually, scientifically it is seen that one atom of hydrogen is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. This was done by some scientist, but it is very, very difficult to measure the weight of one atom of hydrogen. So in the chemistry, we talk about, in the last, we talk about numbers, right? Huge numbers, 1 gram, 2 gram. This is 10 to the power minus 24. Okay. So with this calculation, if weight of one atom of hydrogen is this many grams, so number of hydrogen atoms in 1 gram hydrogen will be how many? 1 by 1.6 10 to the power minus 24, and that is 1 gram by this gram, gram cancel. Solve this, you get 6.2 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. So 1 gram of hydrogen will have these many atoms. These many atoms will actually form, this is less, but lot of tons and tons of this atom. This is 6.3 into 10 to the power minus 10 to the power 23 atoms. Like this piled up will form only 1 gram of hydrogen. Okay, simple maths. Okay, now it is seen that even 12 gram of carbon also has these many atoms. 16 grams of oxygen also has these many atoms. And if you remember, these are molecular mass of hydrogen, carbon, oxygen. Right? This becomes a very unique number because molecular mass, like the general formula, molecular mass grams of any atom has these many number of atoms. You take 12 gram of carbon, 14 gram of nitrogen, 60 gram of oxygen, all these will have these many atoms. Right? This is what is seen experimentally. And if you see the history of this is called Avogadro constant. number, this is a magical number. Nobody believed it will be same. And if you see the history of this, 1811 actually, Italian scientist Voltas. This is guy is Voltas. And in 1811, he proposed that the volume of a gas at any given temperature and pressure is proportional to the number of atoms. That was his proposal. Because in 1811, the chemistry was not advanced. So his theory was a big theory that time, that now we think it is implicit that the volume of a gas will depend on number of atoms. At that time it was not. Number of atoms at a given temperature and pressure. This is what he proposed. Right? Number of atoms or molecules. But the actual proportional value was not determined. In actually 1909, this guy, Jean Pierin, he determined this Avogadro constant. He found that 1 gram of hydrogen has 6.23 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. Okay. So the term mole was used now. Okay. And mole is nothing but molecular mass. If you see the word mole and molecular mass, molecular. From this only this word mole came. So 1 mole of a compound is the molecular mass of the compound actually. Please be with me, it's a new term. 1 mole of compound is nothing but molecular mass of compound. That means 1 mole of carbon will be equal to 12 gram of carbon. 1 mole of oxygen will be equal to 16 gram oxygen. So this reaction, instead of saying one molecule react, two molecules of hydrogen reacts with one molecule of oxygen, you can say that as well. You can say that 2 mole of hydrogen reacts with 1 mole of oxygen gives 2 moles of water. And we know that 2 moles of hydrogen is what? 2 gram. 1 mole of oxygen is what? 16 gram. So those things we know actually, right? So mole and molecular mass, this relation is something we know. So instead of saying, see all this word molecule, mole, molecular mass, all came from the same word molecule. So instead of thinking from the molecule perspective, think from the mole perspective. You see mole, this is 1 mole maybe. And if this is 6.23 into 10 to the power 24. These many atoms consist of 1 mole, and 1 mole is nothing but this molecular mass, right? So 1 mole of compound is nothing but 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules or atom. You talk about 1 mole of water, you talk about 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of water, right? This is 6.023, sorry. Okay, when you talk about 1 mole of oxygen, you talk about these many atoms of oxygen. If you talk about 1 mole, it all depends if you talk about molecules or atoms. So 1 mole means these many numbers of molecules or atoms. Or you just assume molecules itself now, right? So 1 mole means these many molecules. And these many molecules is nothing but molecular mass, because we have seen that these many molecules or atoms actually gives the molecular mass of the atoms or molecules. So now if you see, things are linked. Instead of talking about one molecule or two molecules, we're talking about 1 mole, 2 mole or 3 mole. Why? Because these moles actually can give me the grams, and these grams I can easily measure in the lab. So this is as good as you have this equation. I'll just show you. So this is the equation you have here. Say two molecules of hydrogen react with one molecule of oxygen to give two molecules of water. You react, you multiply the whole equation with this number, the magical number. So with this I can say that 2 into 6.023 molecules of hydrogen will react with 1 into 6.023 molecules of oxygen to give 2 into 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of water. So 2 into these many molecules of water is nothing but 2 moles of, sorry, this into this is 2 moles of hydrogen, this into oxygen is 1 mole of oxygen, and this number into 2 molecules of water is nothing but 2 moles of water. So if you see from the molecule perspective, from the molecule view, we are now in the mole view. 2 mole of hydrogen will react with 1 mole of oxygen to give 2 mole of water. Since we are in the mole, we can easily write the grams. See, 2 mole of hydrogen is nothing but 4 gram of hydrogen. 1 mole of oxygen is nothing but 32 gram of oxygen. And 2 mole of water is nothing but 16 plus 2, 18. 18 into 2, 36. 36 gram. So now if you see directly from the mole, I can write the mass. And if you see here, the law of conservation of mass, 4 plus 32, 36 gram on the left hand side, 36 gram on the right hand side. Thus, understand this concept, very, very important slide for the chemistry. I'll recommend you to pause this video, watch this video 3 or 4 times, 5 times. Make sure your concepts are clear, because this is the basic foundation of chemistry. You understand the mole concept, you understand why we were early talking about the number of molecules, 2 molecules of water, 2 molecules of hydrogen, 1 molecules of oxygen reaction form, 2 molecules of water. This is a perfectly valid statement, but very, very difficult to measure one mass of one molecule, right? You see, the mass of one molecule is so slow, very difficult to measure. You need really hi-fi instruments. We are okay to measure 1 gram, 2 gram. So these guys, Avogadro and this Jean Pierre came up with the concept of Avogadro constant. And with this, the numerically and mathematically, if you multiply this whole equation by 6.023 into 10 to the power 23, there is a golden number. You see that 2 into these many molecules of hydrogen reacts with 1 into these many molecules of oxygen to give 2 into these many molecules of water. And these many molecules of any molecule or compound is nothing but 1 mole. If you talk about these many molecules of water, that becomes 1 mole of water. If you talk about these many molecules of oxygen, that becomes 1 mole of oxygen. These many molecules of hydrogen, that becomes 1 mole of hydrogen. These many molecules of carbon becomes 1 mole of carbon. Very, very good number, magical number, 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. Avogadro constant, very, very important number in the terms of chemistry. Right? So these many molecules actually is nothing but 1 mole. Why this came? Because now 1 mole, the moment I have mole, I can easily write the grams and I can easily validate my statements. 4 gram, 32 gram, 36 gram, very easy to measure in the lab as well. Okay, so please understand why we are doing all this circus is we don't want to measure, or it's very difficult to measure the weight of 1 molecule, but it is easy to measure 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules, and that is nothing but 1 mole, and that is in the grams, and the gram is nothing but the molecular mass. So this formula, that 1 mole of a compound is nothing but these many molecules of that compound, and it is also equal to 1 molecular mass of the compound. This is a very critical formula, very critical observation, and this will be using in a lot of questions. Okay. Since it is a very critical concept, let me write once again here. These many, let's say this is 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules. This is equal to 1 mole. And 1 mole is nothing but molecular mass gram. So for example, let's talk about oxygen. These many oxygen molecules is nothing but 1 mole of oxygen and that is nothing but 32 gram of oxygen versus O2, right? 32 gram. Let's do the same thing for hydrogen, H2. So these many molecules will be nothing but 1 mole of hydrogen, and there is nothing but 2 gram of hydrogen. So you see, this is the molecular mass. This is always 1 mole. We take any compound, it's always 1 mole. You take carbon, this will be 1 mole of carbon, and 1 mole of carbon is 12 gram carbon. Very important concept, please note. 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. Let's talk about molecules now, because most of them exist as molecules. This is nothing but 1 mole of molecule, and it's nothing but molecular mass of molecule. The same formula is true for atoms. 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atom is nothing but 1 mole of atom. Is nothing but one molecular mass of atom. Okay. And I also told you why this mole came, because it is convenient to refer the quantity of a substance in the terms of number of molecules or atoms rather than their mass. It's inconvenient. So we have this new term called mole. See why, I'll tell you. The moment I have this reaction, C plus O2 is CO2. From this you can tell that one molecule of carbon react with one molecule of oxygen to form one molecule of carbon dioxide. You multiply one molecule with this musical number, you get one mole. You can say that one mole of carbon dioxide reacts, carbon reacts with one mole of oxygen to form one mole of carbon dioxide. Right, because one molecule into this magical number is equal to one mole. Right, so looking at the equation, I can just say, but I can't say that 12 gram reacted with 16 grams to give 30 grams. Those things I can't find just by looking at the equation. So it is more convenient to refer the quantity in terms of molecules or atoms. And molecules and atoms are directly, molecules or atoms are directly linked. The only multiplication factor of this constant number. So that means it is very convenient to write in mole also. But it's very difficult to write in the terms of grams. Just by looking at the equation, you can't say that 13 gram reacted with 18 grams or 19 grams. But looking at the equation, you can say that 1 mole reacted with 1 mole or 2 mole. Okay? And 1 mole, we just showed you, that is of any species, atom, molecules, ions or particles. This mole concept is not only for molecule. This is for a molecule, it can be for atom, it can be for ion, it can be for any particles. Okay, so or any particles. Right. So one mole of any species is the quantity that is quantity number having the mass equal to the molecular mass. For example, 2 gram of hydrogen or 32 gram of oxygen or 71 gram of Cl2, 18 gram of water. These are all 1 mole, you see, 1 mole. Now all these will have how many particles? These magical number, 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. Please note, it is experimentally determined and it is called Avogadro constant. It is all experimental value. Okay. So let me repeat this mole constant once again. See, one hydrogen atom mass we have seen was 1 unit, or 1 oxygen atom mass we have seen was 16 unit, correct, or 1 water molecule layer, not atom. Mass we have seen was 8 in unit. This is one mass of one atom or one molecule. Okay. Now you multiply this whole thing with this magical number. 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 hydrogen atoms will be 1 unit into, these will also be multiplied. And this will be value, it will be equal to 1 gram. Multiply this also. So you see, this is 1 into this, this is 1 gram. 16 into this will be how much? 16 gram. Simple maths. This also you multiply. So 1 into 6.0 Avogadro number was 1 gram. So 18 unit into Avogadro number will be 18 gram. And these are nothing but, if you see, molecular mass. So please understand once again, 1 mole is nothing but a pile of 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules, or it can be atoms. That is 1 mole. And this term was introduced in 1896 actually. And this was given by Ostwald. He gave this term, and it's actually derived from Latin word of heap. This is a heap, right? Or pile. So the Latin word of heap is mole. And also it is similar to molecule. That way also, and this term came from this Latin word meaning heap. Right? Why? Because the substance is considered to be a heap or pile of atoms or molecules. That is 1 gram. Okay? And that is the concept of mole. Thank you. Visit our website examfear.com to watch more and more quality educational videos. You can also attend free online tests that are there in our website. You can also get access to tons of free study materials, and you can also find free tutors and mentors in this website. Thanks a lot for watching.